All right. Honoring your season and your rhythm. Welcome, guys. I'm back. You know who I am. I'm Heather Chauvin. This is another episode of the Mom is in Control podcast. Before we dive into today's topic, I want to remind you, if you are not following Mom is in Control on Instagram, head on over there. I'm getting so many amazing questions for the podcast, and I'm still committed to doing a podcast a day for 365 days in 2019. So head on over to Instagram if you are an Instagram user, or maybe send me your questions at support@heatherchauvin.com. So season and rhythm. One thing that I'm a huge advocate of is a morning routine. This is something that I personally struggled with for a really, really long time. I found it extremely challenging as a mother to get up before my children. And so my boys now are almost 14, 9, and 6. And it didn't matter if they were infants or toddlers or what phase they were at. I've always struggled to get up early in the morning. So when people are advocating for the 5 a.m. club, and you have to get up, you have to work out, you have to journal, you have to meditate, you have to do all of these things, it feels overwhelming considering everything else that's on your to-do list during the day. So season and rhythm. When you honor yourself, you honor your soul, you honor your life. One of the shadow sides of being ambitious and having goals and the desire to change is that as women, we often beat ourselves up. I'm not enough. My goal, you know, if you're like, oh, I just want to sleep until 9 o'clock, and you can do that, or 8 o'clock or 7 o'clock, and your goal is to wake up at 5 a.m. and you're just hitting snooze, 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 snooze. Unconsciously, what you're telling yourself is, I am not enough. Look at me, I failed again. I can't even do something simple as a morning routine. There have been times where months I have a really hard time getting out of bed in the morning, and then months I have an abundance of energy and I can work out every single day, and then there's months where I cannot work out. And I'm a huge advocate of journaling and morning pages and just conscious free writing, like pen to paper in the morning. But sometimes my brain's not functioning in the morning. So I have to get into this productive, you know, kind of life hacking and asking myself, when is my most productive time? Is it at 5 a.m.? Is it at 8 a.m.? Is it at 10 a.m.? What do I need to do? So I've noticed a lot of people, the ones that give themselves permission to say, I'm going to use this template and make it my own. What do I need to do? So they might get up, they might, you know, have a glass of water, they might do a little workout, they might eat something, and then maybe they're not journaling until after the kids are up and they're raring to go or something like that. I've been playing with this for years and years and years, and what I have found is exercise I will put off if I don't do it first thing in the morning. It's something I resist. It's also something that I can justify not doing. But the beauty of that is when I do it early in the morning, typically 10 minutes into a home workout, my brain starts like turning on. And then I'm getting inspired and I'm getting creative and ideas are popping into my head. It's like, hey, brain, work up. Or wake up, not work up. Also, the journaling aspect of it. A lot of my clients ask me, like, Heather, what does your journal look like in the morning? Or what do your morning pages look like? And sometimes I'm like, I don't do morning pages every single day. Sometimes I have a lot to say. Sometimes I just write one sentence. And to be honest, sometimes I go weeks without picking up the pen. I'm human. So it really all depends on what I'm trying to create and cultivate in my life. But one of the biggest game changers for me in the last, I would say, 6 months has been honoring my season and my rhythm. What season am I in my life? What am I trying to cultivate? Am I in a push? Well, I'm not a pusher, but am I in like a massive inspired action phase? Am I in a relaxed phase? Am I in a contentment phase? What phase of life am I in? Am I in a phase where I need to really hunker down and be strategically and energetically intentional about my time and energy, because maybe, you know, my kids are going through something, or we have a big, you know, big family situation going on, or maybe there's big things happening in my business. So it all depends. When there's big things happening in my life, the tendency is to want to put your foot on the brake. So for me, what I do is I take that energy and I put it into my morning routine. And I'm extremely intentional about my morning routine. And in those moments when I'm like, I gotta show up big, that's a lot of times when the resistance takes over, right? And you're like, oh my gosh, I don't wanna wake up. I don't wanna do this. And that's when I look at the resistance and I'm like, you are not going to slow me down today. And so I bust through that. And then there's other times when I feel like I need to rest and restore. I've pushed a lot. I've taken action. I was very deliberate and intentional about my energy. And therefore, I'm giving myself permission to back off. So then there's seasons where I get a little lax with my morning routine and I'm not so hard on myself. So today, the message is honoring your season and your rhythm. That if you are a, you know, newbie mom, or you have like a small child at home and you're like, I'm fatigued, I'm tired, I want sleep, then honor your rest. It sometimes doesn't mean that you need to rest more. Sometimes it means you need to do things that bring you more energy, like a morning routine. But if you can just wake up and write 2 sentences down and maybe do some squats, go for a small walk, just do something, some type of ritual to set your day. Sometimes it just depends on where I'm at mentally, but kind of one of my rituals now is I'll open my eyes in the morning, and at my house, I can see through the window, and if the sun's starting to come up, I say thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. I just sit there for a few minutes saying thank you. Honoring your season and your rhythm. I find the direct correlation when you give yourself permission to truly honor where you are at in your season and your rhythm is directly correlated to how you give yourself permission in other areas of your life. And so you might ask me, well, Heather, what does it mean to honor your season and your rhythm? Like, how do I know what season I'm in my life? Think about the life stages. Think about how, you know, like the developmental stages, like, did you just have a baby? Did you just get married? Are you newly single? Are you newly divorced? Are you newly widowed? Are you alone? Are you in a partnership? Are you starting something new? Have you just let something go? Are you in a state of wanting to create massive change and transformation in your life? Or are you in a state where you've been go, 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 go for so long, and now you need to give yourself time and energy and space to rest? What season are you in? Write that down. What season are you in? What's your rhythm? Do you notice that you want to sleep more when you are on your period? Do you notice that when you're ovulating, things are shifting for you? Honor your season and your rhythm. All right, ladies, that's what I have for you today. Check out Instagram, Mom is in Control. Send me your cues. Talk soon.